Welcome to It Could Be Voice, a special broadcast today with a special friend of mine, and we're going to try a special stunty kind of creative thing that I hope you'll enjoy a lot. My very good friend, Fred Tatasciore, is our guest today. Fred is a veteran of more animated TV shows and films than I can count. You can go to his IMDb page and you'll be just floored by what he's been involved in. It's probably easier to just figure out what he's not been involved in, save yourself some time. But anyway, Fred is here. Hey, Fred, it's great to see you.
It's great to see you, Jim. Thank you for that.
We've been working, we've been working together for a lot of years, most recently on Ask the Story Bots, and we're going to do more of that.
Loving that. It's such a fun show. Totally. And I just love it. And I learn stuff from that show. I really do. I mean, I love information, but how are planets formed? It's
how do cell phones work?
Where does the waste go? And it's so fun. it's great. So I'm glad we can do it.
It's nice that we can do it now during this time. You're in your booth there. Adjacent to mine.
You're in your blue room. I'm in my padded cell. Like I say, I always knew I'd live in a padded cell, but not by choice.
Well, great. And, part of our job, Fred, for people that don't know, we are voice actors primarily, and we have to take, words on a page and images that we see of, characters' designs and bring them to life and create the life that's in them and somehow add to whatever the artist has and the writer has created and really make something memorable. And that's how all the great cartoon characters of all time been created. That's what you do with the Hulk and with all the other great characters that you do. And I thought, it might be fun, since we're both also kind of amateur cartoonists, that we could kind of play around with both things. And so we've come up with this challenge, folks, and I hope you find this amusing. We hope we find it amusing too. But I have created three designs, and Fred has created three designs, and we're going to challenge you to pitch. Do yours have names? Because I put names on mine. I thought it would be.
I didn't.
Just say the name. You can just.
We can make it up as we go.
We can make it up as we go.
Because there are certain sounds in my head that I gave them. I'll write them down now.
Write them down now. Yeah. And of course, it's just for fun. We're not actually awarding any prize, although Fred will receive a nice gift in the mail from the government, I think, actually.
They keep trying to do that. I got a phone call today that promised me something.
I don't think I'm going to get anything from them. But
not the American government. To have a scam, too. It's like, oh, really?
Oh, yeah.
He's like, I am an American representative to help you for. I'm like, hold on.
you want your stimulus check? I will bring to your house.
It was like that. I was like, really? Okay. Then, an hour later, I'm like, that was probably real. No,
pissed away $1,400.
Exactly.
All right. Well, when you're ready, we'll get going. You can give if you want. You can give. What do you want? Do you want to take it first, or you want to give it? What do you want?
Whatever you prefer.
All right. If you got one ready there, I'm going to give you the. I'm
going to want me to give a name to it.
Give me a name, and I will create a little speech from that guy.
Okay. This is Yay Guy. Or here we go.
Yay! Oh, this is so great. I'm here on the side of the road. It's 72 hours before the parade, but I wanted to get the best seat that I could. I even made a special flag for it, with a happy face.
Oh, that's so good.
That's Jaeger.
I gotta give you your
Hey, thanks, man. All right. Thank
that
you.
That was fun. Yeah.
Great guy.
I'm sort of sad and desperate, but that's okay.
Yeah. Totally cute. All right. Are you ready for yours?
Here we go.
All right, Fred. Here we go. And this is going to be yours. And this guy's name is Screw Loose.
Hey, you need something fixed? I can do that for you. Toilet, plumbing, any kind of problems? Don't worry about it. I said I've got it under control. No, really. Hey, look at me. You got a car. You can fix that car. I can fix it too. Hey, you want a ratchet? All right, here we go. You know what? I think I made it worse. I'm sorry. Wow.
Yeah. Give yourself a round of applause.
Here we go.
Awesome, man.
Thanks, man.
Screw Loose. Very nice.
Screw Loose is a great name.
Okay, I'm ready for mine.
This is, I just don't why I came to this as faux pas, but like, or naysayer. I don't know. Faux pas, maybe.
Faux pas is good.
Yeah.
I'm not so sure. I think I'll go and consult my notes. Oh, where did I put those notes? Maybe I'd better go make a cup of roast aroma tea, and then I'll try to find those notes. Oh, dear. Oh, my.
Yeah, there's a sort of like, somebody farted.
All right, I got another one for you.
All right, here we go.
Are you ready? Here we go. This is going very well. It's a good experiment.
I love this.
This is what we do all day long anyway, right?
It's true.
There's no difference.
I'm making people.
All right, here we go. This guy is Dave.
From my planet, we always like celebrate things, but your planet, like, okay, I'm thinking, what can we celebrate today? I remember when I was hatched, and that's kind of a day, because my mom made it out of season. But I know that, you know, everything's fine with me. You know, I mean, I turned out okay, right? I like my name, Dave, that you guys gave me in your planet. You can't pronounce my name. My planet is like, and that's just like my surname.
All right. Yeah. Fantastic.
Like fun. That's a great character. It's funny. We almost have a very similar character coming up. Not a voice, yeah, but just like the drawing was very interesting.
All right.
Let me know when you're ready.
I'm ready. Go fire away.
This is Jazz Gator.
Hey, baby. Oh, man. I tell you what, I was having a tough day until I saw you, but now I feel extra good. I won't play you. I won't play a little tune on my horn. Beep, 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 beep. Oh, man, you bring out the Miles Davis and the Louis Armstrong and the Louis Prima, too, I tell you what.
Yes. Yeah, I just knew that was your thing. I was like, Jim's going to have fun with it.
Funny, though. Very similar to Dave.
I know. Isn't that funny? I was like, yeah.
The brothers.
Toothy guys.
Blood brothers.
Well, I just wanted like a Louisiana Gator, you know, yeah. Play like a good jazz.
Louisiana Gator. Yeah, yeah. I could have put a little more Tennessee Williams.
No, I liked it. I like where you went. That was good. That was beautiful.
Well, and you're an improv guy, too, so you make quick decisions, and that's, I think, the key to this.
Boy.
When you do auditions, it's like, I mean, you probably get an idea very quickly when you get the sides. And then do you just kind of go into the booth and go, okay, first idea out of the gate? Or do you munch around a little bit?
I try to do that. I got to say, it really depends on the piece. And if, like, I hear what I think might work, or I have to really read the description and see, like, really what is the tone of this thing? Mm-hmm. What are they really... What do I think they're going for?
Because mm-hmm.
I definitely always have my sort of opinion, but they will, more often than not, some people don't give much description, but some do. Some are right. Like, we want an Alan Rickman type with this thing and this thing. And when you think, okay, what are those notes that I can put in? You know, it's like a bag of tricks, you know, mm-hmm. like what are those things? And then, and if I have I'll try to give them exactly what I think they want. And then if I have a real strong opinion about it, I'll make that my second or third take. You know what I mean? Like, if it's something that strays too far from what they were asking.
Uh-huh.
I mean, and again, pictures really help. You know, yeah. I love seeing the picture.
Yeah.
And I love when they give you a tone or a prototype or a type of, like, okay, this is what we're looking for, this kind of person. I say I mull stuff over a little bit more, unless I don't have time. Mm-hmm. You know, I know some people just love going in there, Johnny on the spot. They go in and they just do it. I have to kind of look at it and then listen. And I listen back now that we're recording from home. I you don't have that luxury as much when you're in the booth because you got to get in and out.
Yeah.
Whereas when I'm at home, I kind of belabor everything a little bit more. And I listen and I'm like, do I buy this? You know, a lot of times I have to like, do I believe me? You know, do I believe it? How about you? Do you have a, do you have a way you go about it?
Or? Yeah, I tend to like kind of go with my first idea because of my improv training. I'm like, okay, there's a lot of potency in that. But then I will think of a variety, and I'll try, maybe you do this too, Fred, try something that I think that only I want to do and that I hope will be an original idea with me. Like you said, you know, all right, what they're asking for is one thing. But then maybe there's this other little idea that I have. And nobody could even describe how to ask for it. And I'll just throw that in there too. And
but
I can't say it's a tremendously successful technique, but because most of the work I do is these days is sound alike stuff and something that, you know, well, I got the job because I sound more, I'm in more in the pocket than the next guy.
Well, you are unusually gifted at that. Like,
I am unusually gifted.
I'm going to say it. No, but really, no, it's you really are. I get that. I mean, there are times when I'm just going, oh, Jim, come on, you're going to do this. You know, like,
but as far as the audition, yeah, I will listen back and see, I guess in a way I'm trying to see, is this convincing to me? Do I feel like this is a thing?
It's just a matter of just hooking into the right character probably too.
Right.
You know what I mean?
And it's an art form. So the creators are looking for what tickles them and what they hear in their head. And, you know, it is what it is.
I know. If you told me, you know, 30 years ago or 20 years ago, like that all the Shakespeare training and all the theater stuff, so much of that was going to go into games, video games,
right?
You know, and that improv was going into TV animation. You know what I mean? Like it's really funny where things, I mean, that's not a hard, fast rule. It's just, it's funny how that really did come up.
It got 100%. Yeah. All right. Well, I got one more drawing for you, Fred. One more design. Right up here. Here we go. Here we go. And this is your last character for today. And I hope you enjoy it. Please meet Arlo Squabble.
Oh, hey, thanks. Thanks a lot. You know, I'll tell you, let me say, he might be a little smaller. Yeah, you know, I gotta say, it's really great to be here on your show. You're doing a lot of things with the pictures, and I used to dabble in that. I enjoyed that back in back east. And I tell you something, Mike. I enjoy going to the track. I lose a lot of money. My wife, I love her. I mean, she makes me nuts. But you know, I really love her. But that makes her upset. I gamble quite a bit, and I probably shouldn't. But I feel like there's always going to be that winning moment. You know, the time when something's going to happen for me. For Arlo Squabble. You know, I it's about time that something good happens for me. That's all I'm saying. Anyway, I'm going on and on. Look at that. All right. Well, you take care now, and I'll see you around.
Oh, yeah.
See, the soundboard is... It's always good, especially if you're really depressed. You're like, you know, yeah. I got to tell you, it's really been a hard time for me lately. No, really, it's not. It's not funny. Okay, I'm getting a divorce. Okay, guys, seriously, it's not funny. All right, you know, shut up.
Oh, that's great. That's great, Fred. Well, this was a fun experiment.
I love those characters you drew.
Thank you.
Arlo's sweet.
He's a sweet little guy. Yeah. He is definitely. He's a sweet little guy.
Yeah.
Well, and it's funny. It's a funny, funny miracle that we can look at drawings and bring them to life and kind of hear in our mind what they would sound like. And it's really fun play.
It is a very fun thing to do. And it's because animation is sort of both. It's everything. You know, I try to tell some students that, you know, an animated character, whether it's in a game or a movie or whatever, it's a few people. You know, you had someone who wrote it, someone who drew it, someone who's animating it or using it in gameplay. And then there's, you know, the actors. And we're a kind of a team. It's like it's puppetry. You know, I mean, animation is puppet. It's like the slowest acting you'll ever do. Instead of saying, hey, Jim, you're going. You know,
right.
and so it's it's such a thrill to like look at something and go like, how it talks to you. The picture sometimes will talk to you.
Right.
Say like, that's what this guy sounds like. Or another fun exercise is kind of a fire sign theater. This is a Phil Proctor area, but like we love him. Just turn off the sound on the TV and make the voices for the for the ads and the people. That's a fun thing to do too. Soap operas are the best for that. You can say anything. You can
long
say
takes.
Yeah. You can say, I will destroy you. You can destroy people in soap operas. It's great. Even animation, when you draw something, it'll speak. The character will speak to you. It's like, what does this thing want to say? You know? It's like some sculptors will look at rock and say, I see what this thing's going to be or what it needs to be. And I feel like when you get a great drawing from someone or anything, you know, you just go, well, what's this thing sound like? You got to look at its mouth. What does it want to say? You know?
Yeah. Art is a communication always.
It really is.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, great, man. This has really been fun. We'll do it again sometime.
I love you, man. It's love so good. So great to jam with you.
Yeah. Really. So where can people find you if they want to find you and talk
right
to you?
In this booth. I'll be here. I don't leave. I'm trapped really within this screen. So I'm moving out.
We're working really hard to get you out, mate.
Please, it's man. Anytime you can, that would be great.
Instagram,
Twitter, Instagram. My name, I think it's down there. Tatasciore, yeah, Instagram and Twitter. The Twitter's with my name.
Okay.
And the Facebook with my name. Yeah.
Okay.
I'm trying to get better at the social medias, but I'm trying to get better at it. So if I don't answer all the everything right away, folks, don't be offended. I'll get to you.
Okay, great. All right. Well, that's it for It Could Be Voice. Thanks very much, Fred Tatasciore. I'll see you soon, my friend.
Take care, my friend.
All right.
It's so good to see you. Bye, everybody.
Bye. Incredible Fred Tatasciore. Thanks for watching, everybody.